Welcome back to the Cyclos 4 instruction videos. This video will show you how to customize the layout of Cyclos. Once you understood how to do this, you will see that the possibilities are endless. For advanced customizations, some basic knowledge of HTML and especially CSS is needed. In this video, we will do the following. First, we will upload a new logo and customize the header. Then we will create some new menu links. Subsequently, we will create some banners, and finally, we will customize the theme. Well, first, make sure that you log in as an administrator that has permissions to customize a configuration. You can have different configurations, and in this way, for different users, Cyclos can have a different layout. So let's sign in. In this case, we will sign in as a global administrator, but you can log in as many administrators in this case. So we will go to System Management, Configurations. We can also use the short links here, but we will do it through the configuration because it's important and that everybody knows that all these things are attached to the configurations. So for example, if Group A has this configuration, we are now editing the layout of Group A. And probably all groups will have a default configuration and they can have some extensions. So for example, the logo will be in the default configuration and will be for everybody the same. So let's change the logo and we will upload a new system logo. And we will use this logo. It's uploading. And we can see now the new logo is uploaded. We have the shortcut icon. That's the icon that is used in the left top of your browser. And we have the reports logo. That can be a little bit a different logo if you want. But well, in our case, we will use the same logo for the reports. The reports are the things that are printed on PDF, for example. So let's refresh Cyclos and see if indeed yes, we can see indeed we have the new logo now. If we still want to add some text or add a little bit more things to this header, we can do that. So let's go to content, and in content you see the header, and we chose to customize the header, and we will put something next to it, and that will say welcome to Cyclos provided by the social trade organization to stimulate durable economic growth, sustainable economic growth. Okay, now we added this. Well, actually, we want it in two lines, three lines provided by the social trade organization. So we want it like this. Then we have to do some CSS editing if we want to really make it nice. But let's save it first and see how it looks now. So let's save it. And let's refresh our Cyclos instance. And we see, okay, now it looks like this. Well, this is not so nice, so let's go to content again. And we can actually already do it like this a little bit. So we say align to the left. And it will already be a little bit better. So we do like this. And we will give some padding on the right or some margin at the right. So let's give 30 margin. Let's close again. So now there's more room here. Okay, well, we'll do for now. Of course, you should hire some professional web editor to really make this nice. And the only problem now we see is that the height of the header is not so good. So let's improve that a little bit by also give some padding on the bottom of this image. So let's go to this image again and or margin at the bottom. So let's make it 30 pixels to the right, 30 pixels below. Ah, 20 is enough. Okay, let's do that. It's saved. And let's save it here. And let's refresh and see what happens. Okay, well, that's good enough for now. Of course, you can make really nice designs in the header, but at this moment we won't do that. Well, this is of course very easy. Let's go now to the menu links. They're also quite straightforward and easy, but let's just show it so you know how it works. Well, here you see, for example, the information button, and under this information button you will have social trade, future overview, and download. Okay, let's go back here to the menu, social trade, future overview, and then download. So we can add some extra button here, and it will be a menu group. A group can, like information, that's a menu group, and it can contain multiple menu items. So let's create a menu group, and let's call it test. It will be always visible, or only for guests. You can set it exactly to how you want. The position is both. Actually, we only show it on the forefront menu. We'll save it. And then we go back to the configuration and to the menu, and then we will create a new menu item. This menu item will be under test, and we will make it test one, and it will be an external URL, and it will link to HTTP. Okay, let's save it, always visible, and let's go back, and here we see under test there's now test one, and let's see if this is really the case. If we refresh, then under test there's now test one. Well, this is very good, and if we click on test one, it will go to this external URL, which is the site of the social trade. Well, that's very nice. So we go back and it works like it should. That's also quite easy. So can I explain a little bit more about this? No, it will be, well, it depends a little bit on what kind of, if you can create a content page here too, then you can directly edit some content here. Well, that is quite straightforward too, and it works with the same RTF text editor as you already see. You can give the page a title, and well, let's not go further into details here because it's quite straightforward. Well, now we will create a banner for you. So let's do that. We go to the configuration again, and we go to banners, and we will add one banner, and the name of the banner will be a test. It will be always visible. We can apply the theme background and border. Let's do that, because that's now, then it will look nice. Otherwise it will look probably a little bit strange. We will put them here on the left, and we'll just put something test. We put in it, we save it, and it should already be visible. So let's refresh. So if we go down, we see here test, 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 and we see indeed it uses the same background and stuff as the menu here and all these things. If we would put this out, it will just be a banner like this. And you can really make your own CSS around it, and you can make it look exactly the way you want it yourself. And if you are a web editor, don't hesitate to use the HTML, and you can just make your own div, for example. You can give it a style, so you can say, for example, the background color should be white, the border should be 1 pixel, it should be solid. Well, let's do a dash border actually, and it should be black. Okay, let's see if I did everything correctly. I think so. Let's save it, and let's see what happens if we refresh. So indeed we have here Well, it looks like that, and it's funny. Okay, we will still, yeah, but it looks nice enough. We can do some margin inside and stuff, but well, the content, well, it's clear how it works. You can inspect it here with Firebug if you want, and change it and copy the HTML to here, so finally it fits nicely into the site. Okay, that is for what the banners are. So to still show the other content items, so we can customize this part, we can customize the banners here, we can also put some banners on the right still if we want. We can customize the footer is shown here, we can customize it here, and we can change the logged users homepage and the guest homepage, so that's just this page. And well, we will leave them the same at this moment because well, they can just all be edited with the RTF text editor, so it's quite easy to do that. Well, we arrived at the final stage, and the final stage is the themes. Okay, so you can just pick some themes that are available in the system, but you can also make your own theme, and let's make our own theme. And let's base it on the theme we are using currently. And the current theme we are using is the inherited blue-gray full menu. So let's do the blue-gray background full menu. So that's this one. So we will create now a new theme based on the theme we are currently using. Let's do that. Okay, and we will say that our own theme, call it. Me. Okay, we will save the theme just to show that it will be created, and we go to configurations. Well, to our configuration. Sorry, clicked on the wrong part. We go to themes, and we will say, okay, well, we will use now our own theme for guests and for locked users. So we apply the selected themes. Okay, so now we really are using our own theme when we refresh, but since it's based on the same theme, the layout should not be changed. Let's see what happens. Okay, indeed, the layout didn't change. Okay, so what we can do now, we go to the theme again, and now we can really start editing the theme, and things will start looking different for us. So let's edit some nice things we can do. So first of all, we don't want this, although it's very nice, we want another, not this blue color here. So let's make another color for the menu. So, and we will make the menu size not completely, but we will make it the size of the page itself. So we go to the menu, and we will do that. The height of the height, the size will be the content. The horizontal menu top background color will be, well, we will make a little bit a yellow or a green. Let's do some green. Okay, it's very bright green here. Okay, I will use this color. I will copy it, and because I copied it, I can paste it now. Sorry, this is Dutch. You see here. Paste it now. Say select. See if it works. It should work. This is still a little bug here I see in the system, but we will solve that very soon. So I have to pick it by hand now, and I will select a much darker color for the bottom. And let's see what color it's white now. That's good. So let's save it and let's see what happens when we refresh. Sometimes the saving costs a little bit of time because we are using less CSS and it has all to be generated. So that can cost some time. And now we see we have a beautiful green menu, but we still see that the selected ones are still in blue. So, well, actually, I just thought I was a little bit lazy and let's not do it, but we have to do it. So let's pick some lighter green colors for that. So really, we'll make a very bright color here. And something like this. Probably it will be a bit ugly, but let's see what happens. Let's refresh. Refresh, take some time. Okay, and now we see it fits better into the screen theme. It's not optimal yet, but well, you have to take some time to experiment with it. And you see now it looks nicely together, works with the logo a little bit. We could have picked colors that were a little bit closer to the logo, but well, we can do that later. Okay, so well, we really have our own layout already a little bit. We can just do anything here we want. We can give the text different colors, we can give the sections different colors. So let's actually also make some green things into the. Okay, select and save. I will refresh. And now you see also these titles are in green. So now we have a really nice green theme. But it might be that this is not enough for you. And what you then can do is you can just create your own style. This style will always override the current style. So you can just do things in Firebug and change the CSS and see if you like it. And if you like it, you can just declare it here and the site will look exactly what you want. So you can really do a lot with CSS. So you can really change the complete look and feel. Okay, now let's seriously mesh things up now, just to show you how much is possible with only editing the CSS. Of course, when you do this, please test Cyclos very well before you publish it live. But you can publish it in a configuration which is not shown to your users, and then switch to that theme. So in that sense, you have an excellent area to play around and try to customize the CSS. So let's do some radical stuff now. It's very handy to use Firebug for this because it will give us a lot of information. And this last style screen sheet will just be loaded as the last style sheet. So when the if you know a little bit of CSS, the last style sheet will always override the other style sheet, but elements that are more specific than this element will override this element again. So let's do that. So for example, we can we see the footer is described here, and we can just say okay. And well, the footer, we don't have any display property, so we can just hide, for example, if we don't like the footer. We can copy it here and we can say okay, the footer, and we don't want to display it because, well, we don't need it. You can of course change it in another way, but just if you want to quickly disable it using CSS, it's very easy. Just add this CSS style to the footer, not to display it. So we save it and we refresh. Now the footer should be gone, and indeed the footer is gone. Well, also this banner we can just turn off, but just let's do it in another way today. Let's just turn it off roughly by CSS. So we say okay, we don't want any banner. Okay, save it. I won't refresh because I believe it will be okay. And let's do something funny now. For example, let's try to put this menu on top of it. I don't know if it's possible, but let's try if we can do it. So we are here in this left menu that is part of something that's called main left. And it's float left at this moment. So the float left we have to put off. So we float. Yes, that will work. Margin right, we can make 0 pixels off. Minimal height, well, 1 is good. And the width, we just can make unlimited because, well, we don't need it anymore because it will just be a block because a div is default a block and it will take the whole space which we want. So let's add this here too. Float known, margin 0 pixels, minimum height 1 pixels, and white we will delete. Okay, let's save it. Will take a little bit of time all the time you do this. Let's refresh now, because this is probably still the firebug settings that are loaded, but after we refresh it should not be anymore. Okay, that is perfect. So now indeed these things are shown on top of each other, which we wanted, but still this doesn't take the menu, doesn't take the whole width, which is too bad. So let's see why it doesn't take that. The main content is taking all the space, but the main left is not taking all the space. And why not? Good question. Let's put it on display block and see if that helps. No. What's happening? White auto. Probably, I see here is still a width set of 205, and here the newer CSS doesn't have the 205, so we have to override this 205 by making it a width auto. So let's do that, because we have to override, that's very important. So remember, indeed, everything you save here, these values will keep being the same, but you have to override it here in the CSS. So you cannot just delete it, you have to make a value that overrides the other value. And now it should be good. Well, now we want these menus to be displayed next to each other, so let's try to do that. So let's see, we have here the left menu. And then the list in the left menu, we want to be floating to the left. Let's see if we can make that work. I hope I do this correctly. Left menu, and then in the menu, the list. And then we want it to display block. No, sorry. Wanted to float to the left. And let's see what happens. Okay, it's saved. Well, I'm very curious if it worked. It didn't work so long if it sees any S anymore, so I don't know if. Okay, perfectly. It's all stacked nicely next to each other. The only thing we need to do now is make sure this element fits over the complete element. And let's try first how to do that, because it's easier to check here quickly. I think it's overflow hidden. Yes, it works. Okay, so let's now try that here. And we, which element was it? The left menu. We have the left menu here. No, main left. No, we still have to declare it. Left menu. Overflow. Hidden. Save it. Okay, it looks perfectly now. Perfectly. We still miss the size here, it's still a bit small, but first let's refresh, and indeed it works. That's already something. And now it would be nice if this thing would also be a little bit bigger. So let's see how we can do that using Firebug. The main center, we have a width declared here. If we put it off, it will get smaller, but we also have to override the float, and the float will be none. And then it looks like it works, so in the main center we have to do things, and we don't have a main center declared yet, so let's do it. Main center, and we say float none, and we say We set it to auto because we have to override this value it had. We cannot just delete it. Okay, we save it. And let's hide the firebug. And let's refresh the page now. And well, it seems like it's working, so let's see how it looks in some other pages. Okay, well, as you see, we completely customized the look of Cyclos now. It can be done just only using CSS. Of course, you have to check if you didn't break a page, because that would be very well possible, because, well, the CSS is made very specifically. And it seems like no pages are broken yet. Let's see the home. Okay, here we have someone that's broken. So this one has to be fixed before we use this new theme. But well, we can also do that with CSS. Just make class for all, just adapt the CSS for all these elements here, and it will work. Okay, well, this is well the more advanced CSS configuration. Let's see if we can explain still some other things about the layout that are important. Well, first of all, here the banners we explained. Let's see the themes we explained. In the themes, there are still some other things we can explain, and that are the theme custom images. For example, if I want to use this forest image in my own CSS somewhere, I can upload it here and I can use it in my CSS. So that's and it will be saved with a theme, so that's very nice. And you also have the theme images, that are the default images for the theme. And for example, if I don't like this out of stock icon, it's a bit strange out of stock icon, actually. It's probably wrong, but I can replace it here. Or if I don't like the close button, or I don't like well any of this images that can be found in the theme, I can upload a new one here, and it will be displayed differently. So you can easily customize all those things if you want. And one last thing that is important when playing with the configurations, and that is, I want to show you two little tips for working with content pages and working with this editor. It's not optimal, but it can do a lot. It can especially do a lot when you just use the HTML. The first thing I want to show you is, please use this icon to drag it a little bit bigger, because that's quite nice, because you need some space to edit your page. That's tip number one. Tip number two is, when you click on an image and hold it, you can see you drag it, and you see that you have a little cursor. Do you see this little cursor here? That's very nice, because then you know exactly where the image is in the HTML. So for example, it's good to put it on the first line, and so you know, okay, it's on the first line, and the way it's aligned then is relative to this first line. So now it's aligned to the right, and it's on the first line, so it's on top. If it's on this line, it will be under the text, and it will be to the right. So that's important to know. Those two little tips you just need to know, and then you can easily work with images. Okay, well, that's all. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I hope you learned something, and please watch our other videos. Okay, thank you. Bye-bye.